Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Coffee and Conversation with Kristen. So today I wanted to specifically talk about income. One of the specific incomes I want to talk about is a variable income, otherwise known as your hourly wage, okay? When we have a stable income, meaning we have a two-year history, what we do with hourly income is we take a two-year average. So a lot of times the mistakes I'm seeing when people are filling out our application is they automatically put in 40 hours a week at their rate, which seems like it's pretty good, right? Even if there is some overtime. The thing about it is though, I bet you 9 out of 10 times when somebody's calculating their hourly income for me, or when they finally get me their pay stubs and I actually do the income calculations for them, I'm finding even though there might be some overtime, that the actual hourly income is typically falling short of 40. Maybe one week you worked 30 and took a little time off. Maybe another week you worked 38 hours, and then one week you work 40, and then maybe another week you decided to take Friday afternoon off, so there's really only 36 hours, okay? If you can tell, the trend is not 40 hours a week. The trend is somewhere in the upper 30s on average for hourly income. Well, if I'm losing 2 hours at $20 or $30 an hour for income, that's a big difference in your overall income that I can use for qualifying, okay? The other aspect of that is because hourly income is a variable income, let's say in 2019 you made more money than 2020. That's a decline in income, which means now we have to use the lower of the two, okay? If there's an increase in income, that's great. That's even more stability. So what we're doing when we're qualifying you is we're doing what's called a pre-underwrite almost. We're really taking in your information, your true income, the way an underwriter would look at it, and what we can use for qualifying. Even when you're a full-time employee, it doesn't necessarily equate to straight 40 hours a week, okay? We have to get those pay stubs. Minimum of 30 days pay stubs along with your last 2 years W-2s. We then compile that information. The other mistake that I see happen a lot is people think because they've had overtime for a couple months that we can use that overtime to qualify. The key note is again, it's a variable income, which means we have to show a two-year history of overtime income in order to use it. So what I find is that when I call people and explain to them what their true income is, what we can use on the mortgage side of things, it then can change to what maybe they can qualify for into that debt to income ratio. Okay, so variable income is a really big component in this. Again, I'm specifying hourly income, especially hour with overtime right now, because that doesn't always mean that we're using a straight 40. I see a lot of employers paying overtime on a daily basis and not necessarily a weekly. So maybe if you work 10 hours of one day, you got paid for 8 and 2 hours of overtime, which is great. But then maybe you fell short a couple other days and only worked 7 hours instead of 8. Well, now I don't have 40 hours plus 2. Get my drift? So that's where it matters. Calculating that income, again, if I lose a couple hours a week on average at $20 or $30 an hour, that can be a big deal in your qualifying. So it's really important when your lender asks you for 30 days pay stubs, we get those 30 days pay stubs. It's not that we don't believe you. We believe many cases you are working 40 or close to it. However, there are a lot of times we're also seeing where somebody thinks they work 40 and they don't really quite work 40. They maybe work 37 or 38 on average. So it's a big deal. Again, overtime, you do need a two-year history. Bonus income, you need a two-year history. Commission income, you need a two-year history. On the hourly, we typically ask for a two-year history because, of course, again, it's variable. However, if you were just a student, this is an exception to the rule. If you were just a student and you finished school and your first job just came up and it's hourly, okay, we will look at that. However, we're going to need a verification of employment to make sure that that hour, that 40 hours is stable, and we're gonna need a minimum of those 30 days pay stubs. If you don't have a W-2 on hand, because it's still too new, those pay stubs are going to be critical, okay? So talk to your lender about it to make sure that you're qualifying in those areas. They want to help and they want to make sure they're qualifying you right. We want to make sure that we're not giving you a pre-approval letter based on income that isn't correct. And then when you bring us an offer, we don't qualify you, so now you have to cancel. That is not what we want at all. When we're asking for those pay stubs for your pre-approval, when we're asking for those W-2s, it is to help you so that we are getting you out in the market to be the most successful buyer you can be and to take that loan to the closing table. I'm happy to talk about any incomes anytime to help you understand more, but if you want to get a little bit more information on hourly income or any of the variable incomes there are, I'm happy to have a conversation. Drop your comments below, shoot me a text, give me a call, and we will get all your questions answered so that you are better prepared for the mortgage qualifying incomes. Thank you so much and have a great day. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.